Hey everybody, welcome back to Twitch TV Studios. Today I'm going to be showing you how to configure your Xbox controller to work in the Wiimote Nunchuk configuration, which is most used in Super Mario Galaxy and Super Mario Galaxy 2. Now before we begin, let me preface this by saying this does not work for Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword. I have a lot of people asking me for the best configuration to use an Xbox controller with Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword, and I've got to say it's pretty impossible. It can be done, but the motion plus input support on Dolphin isn't very good, and it's pretty much impossible to play, so I'm not going to be recommending it for that. So sit back, relax, get your knickers out of a twist, hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, and let's just dive into it, shall we? So the first thing you're going to want to do is go to the controller section in Dolphin, and go to a bit where it says emulate the Wii's Bluetooth adapter down here, and click Wii Remote 1. Make sure that it says emulated Wii Remote, and click configure. Then in the device section, click the X input 0 gamepad, or it will say 1 gamepad, depending on how many you've got there. If your Xbox controller does not appear, then click refresh. Make sure that it is connected. Click refresh, and it will appear in this section here. Next, you're going to want to go over to the extension bit here and make sure that Nunchuk is selected. And then it will open these things here and deselect attach motion plus, because we don't need motion plus for Super Mario Galaxy 2. Our motion plus support with Dolphin is pretty experimental and not very good at the minute anyway. For the buttons, the A button, you're going to click that and then press the A button on your controller, and it will assign it to button A. And to make sure it works, press button A and it will go bold every time you press button A. Now for the B button, the B is kind of like the trigger that you shoot the stars at, so you're going to want to attach that to the right trigger. For 1 and 2, I use X and Y. Then for the minus and plus, I use the start and select, or the start and back button as it's called on the Xbox controller. And then for the home button, I use the left analog stick in. So I push the left analog stick in for the home button. So for the D-pad, you're going to want to set the D-pad on your Xbox controller. So up, down, left, right. And then if you want the rumble motors, if you click on the motor section, select motor L, click on operators where it says R, and select motor R, click select, and it should look like this, motor L, the line down the middle, then motor R, click apply, and then click test to make sure that's working and my controller is rumbling. Next, we're going to want to click the motion simulation section, and the shake bit is for the jump, the shake jump, so I'm assigning this to the right bumper. So whenever I press the right bumper, it's going to simulate shaking the Wiimote. So X, right shoulder, right shoulder, right shoulder. As you can see there, every time I press the right shoulder, it simulates a shake on the Wiimote. The point section, I just use the right analog stick. So where it says up, I push the right analog stick up, down, left, and right. And then to hide it, I'm going to use the right analog thumbstick. And now, as you can see, every time I move around here, and if it isn't working or it's going too fast, then you click the calibrate button and move your right analog stick slowly around this section here. As you can see, it draws a circle, and click finish calibration. And that should help with the sensitivity issue. Next, we're going to want to go to the extension section, and now we're going to configure the Nunchuk. So use the left analog stick for this. So it says up, left analog stick up, down, left, and right. As you can see, as I move it around, the red dot moves around too. Now you can calibrate this too by clicking the calibrate button and slowly moving the left analog stick all the way around. Click finish calibration, and that should run a lot smoother. Now for the C and Z buttons, I put the C button to the left shoulder and the Z button to the left trigger. The left shoulder, left trigger. And that's all you need to do for most of the game. So let's fire up the game and see how that runs. So now, as you can see, Mario is running around pretty fine. He's jumping. I can move the motion support around with the right analog stick. It is extremely sensitive, so that is something you're going to have to get used to. I haven't really seen a fix for that right now, but if you focus and concentrate enough, it is very, very easy to control. And if I want the right analog stick to go away, I just hold in the thumbstick and it will disappear. If I press the right bumper, then it will simulate the shake, as you can see there. One of the things you might find difficult when playing this game is using Yoshi's tongue with the right analog stick and the right trigger. but with enough practice, it does become relatively easy. And the beautiful thing about this game is that you only need to hover near it for Yoshi's tongue animation to work. As you can see, I am pretty much bossing it right now. It's not as perfect, as precise as having a remote nunchuck configuration, but you can get through most of the game like this. So once you've confirmed all that's working, you're going to save that profile. So exit the emulator, click controllers again, go down to the bit where it says configure again, configure the emulated Wii remote. Type anything you want into here. So I'm going to go for Super Mario Galaxy Standard. And click save, and that is going to save my configuration. Now that's going to get you through a lot of the game where there are points where you're going to need to use the tilt mechanic, and you're going to need to use separate profiles for that. So you can alt tab back to this bit and change the profile to it. I have two settings for this, one for the ball and one for surfing. So for the ball one, let's take a look at that. And that changes the tilt animation to the right analog stick. So when you tilt forward and tilt backwards like you're supposed to on the ball, then you can control it using the right analog stick. So let's see how we get there from the Super Mario Galaxy Standard one that we have here. So you're going to want to load your Super Mario Galaxy Standard one by going to the profile section, clicking your new profile, clicking load, and it'll load it back up. Then go back to motion simulation, and here where it says point, you're going to want to middle click on your mouse to clear all of this. And then on the tilt bit where it says forward, backward, left, and right, use the right analog stick. Now when you use the right analog stick, it will simulate tilting the Wiimote. It is not advisable to do both of these at the same time, which is why I use separate profiles. Once you've done this, go to click to the bit where it says profile here and type in the name for it. Ball 2. I'm going to put ball 2 because I've already got one saved. And click save. And the other profile that you're going to use is for surfing. Now this one I have set up so that when you tilt, when you use the left and right triggers, it will simulate tilting left and right, and when you press the Y button, it will simulate tilting forward. So to make this one, you're going to want to start from a fresh profile again. So where it says reset, click clear. I've got button A and button B. I attach them to A and B, and then the start button here, just in case. The D-pad, up, down, left, and right on the D-pad. And then in the motion simulation section, went forward to be Y, and left and right to be the triggers. And here on the point section, we put up, down, left, right on the right analog stick. And then for the shake, I put the shake on the X button. And then for the extensions, again on the nunchuck, we use the left analog stick. So up, down, left, and right. And then calibrate to that, so it works fantastic again. And then the C button, I use the back button, which is also the select button or the share button on the PlayStation controller. And then for the Z button, I use the left shoulder or L1 on the PlayStation. Then that can be surfing 2, because I've already got one there, but you can call it surfing, save. So whenever you have a surfing section on the Mario game, which requires you to tilt left and right, you can use the left and right triggers. So what you're gonna want to do is to alt tab out the game, come here, load up your surfing profile, click load, go back into the game, use it, and then once that level is over, come back, use your Super Mario Galaxy Standard one, click load, and it will load them back up. So you're going to need 3 profiles to play this game with all of the features. If that sounds like too much, then you can connect your Wiimote to Dolphin using Bluetooth. If you have Bluetooth, I'm going to show you how to do that in a future video. That's everything for this video. If you've liked this video, please hit that like button. If you're new here, please consider subscribing to the channel. And remember, don't do anything I wouldn't do.